So you'll notice, first of all, over in the card class, there is no main. That's because the main is actually here in Card Tester. Here in the main, we're going to create a new card, and we have to pass it three parameters: its rank, its suit, and its point value. So I've created three different cards here, two of which are the exact same, so we'll be able to test the matches method, and then I made a third one. So now that I've created these things, your first job is to run this code, make sure it works, and now we'll print out some methods. Let me show you what I mean. And I didn't necessarily mean methods as much as I meant print out some of this data. So this first one, I just print out some junk letting you know that I'm testing it. And then I'll say what the rank is, and I'll get the rank accessor method, and then the suit and the suit accessor method. So I'm trying out that all of these methods that I make work, and then I'll also use the toString, and it'll print out the whole string. And then I'll print out a space, and then I'll do the same thing for the rest. So I'm gonna put that in now. Cool. So now I have another test and another test, and then a matching test. And I'll see if this one matches with this card, and I'll pass it the other card, which is the other card inside our function, inside the method of the class card. And I'll try it again. So this one should return as true, and this one should return false. And that it should just say false right there, and it should just say true right here. When I run this thing. So, your first assignment on Thursday is to build this card tester and get it running. And to get it running means that you're going to need to fix your Eclipse problems, which means you may need to explore a different IDE or YouTube the snot out of this problem and find out why it's not running and figure out what you need to do to get it running in Eclipse or download NetBeans or download BlueJay and just double click and open it with those guys. So there's your options. So once you've done this activity, once you've gotten Card Tester and you've gotten some tests in there and you have also been able to execute it and run the code and then commit and push it, now we're going to make two new files. So the first file that we're going to make will be this deck.java. So create a new file, deck.java. I'll post this starter code, the activity 2 starter code. I'll post it in Slack and anywhere else I can put in your reach. And then, so what you're having to do here, the biggest challenge you're going to have is this, where you will need to create an array list. An array list is pretty tricky. It's like an array, but it has extra methods that can be convenient in adding and subtracting cards. You can like pop things out of the array list or add things in. So here's what I'd need to do. I'd create cards as a single variable, like so, and I'll need to do a new array list, and it's inside the array list will be a card with a capital C, card, sorry, new IDE. And so an array list of card objects, and there we go. So now I have an array list holding all of my cards, and you can see up here. There's a list, and now it's all set up. So cards has been configured. So now what I'll be able to do is when deck gets called, I get a string of ranks. So all of the different so not every game you'll need face cards. So in 11, for instance, in 11s, you don't use the face cards. So in order to know what kind of deck I want to create here in my constructor, I need to know what ranks you want in the deck, all 52 cards or what. So what I'll do is I'll create a for loop right here. So I'll say something like for int x equals 0, x is less than ranks dot length. So I'll find out how many items are in the array, and I'll loop that many ranks. So it should look something like this. Now here's where it gets even trickier, and this is why I'm helping you guys out with this video. So now this will loop through all of the ranks of the cards, but inside each one, I'll need to loop through. Each rank is going to have four different suits, typically, one would assume, and so I'll need to create that within each one. So for example, I'll need to do for, and here's where I'm going to make a new string variable, and it's going to be, let's say, suit string, and this is the little bit of Java magic here. And what I'll do is I'll create a variable, and this suit string will go through each one of my array of suits. It will go through each one in the array, and this will be the current one that I'm on. So this will iterate through each one of the all of my list, and this will be the acting variable for that. And you'll see why I need that. So over here, I'll now create the new card. So card.add. So I'll pop a new item into my list here. So I need actually cards.adds. So I'll add an item into this array list, and I'll do new card, and now I'll do ranks and J. So that means I will be inside the ranks list on currently J. So I get handed this array as a parameter when I'm setting up the deck. And I'm looping through I'm looping through all of the ranks, and J is my variable that I'm using to loop through the length of ranks. So right here, this will be a 1, 2, up to king, or whatever I'm using. And then I need to do the suit string, and this is the current suit that I'm on, spade, diamond, whatever. And then the values, that I was given an integer array, and so I'll do that values also using J, because presumably the values will be the exact same as the string ranks. So they're the same, it's just that this is an integer equivalent of this. So I can just use the ranks J and the values J. So this is gonna need a bunch of like parentheses and a semicolon. I think I need another parenthesis there. And so this is the big loop that I'm trying to show you guys about. It'll iterate through, and we haven't talked about array lists yet. We know a little bit about arrays, and so it's not too hard to understand an array list. It's just an array with list functions. So you have at things like dot add, which are very convenient. So that's all that we're doing here. And so we're making all of the cards and populating the deck. Now the rest of this stuff you should be able to figure out. How to handle all of this. I think the trickiest part will be the deal method. And the deal method's tricky only because you need to first check if the is empty. And if is empty is true, then you just return nil or whatever. Otherwise, you reduce the size. So there's a size variable up here. So you do size minus minus. And then you'll need to create so that your card C. So you'll make some sort of card. Excuse me. And what you'll do is you'll use the size variable to get the top of the deck. So here I'll do whatever the is empty if so return null. So I'll do that up here, and then I'll do size minus minus, and then card. I'll just use some cr t create some temporary variable, and then I'll do cards.get and my current size. And the dot get method is again a useful thing for an array list, and it will retrieve at the parameter, so whatever item it is in the list. And so since we know how many cards are in this deck because of size, we will use that as the parameter to get the current card at the top of the deck, and we'll stick it into the variable C, and then we'll just return C. And that way you'll get the card that's on the top of the deck so that we can deal them out. So that's your current deal. So I hope this sort of makes sense. The two string thing is largely done for you already, it looks like, which is, I think, a little bit soft. You guys, see if you can make sense of what that means. It's a little tricky, but not too hard once you've get over some of the return and you actually see what's happening here. But for the most part, just fill in the rest of these functions, get the thing working, and go back to the first activity over here, this card tester that we looked at. So get this thing cranking. Yeah, and hit me up on Slack if you have any questions.